In the previous class, we discussed the Faraday's laws. Okay, so let's just take a recap. The first law of Faraday, it said that W that is equal to ZIT, right? Where Z was the electrochemical equivalent. So the value of Z, that was the atomic mass upon N into 96500. Now this is the weight when we are calculating for solid substances which are generally deposited at the cathode. But in electrolysis, we had discussed the other day that at anode mostly the gases they are given out, right? Or the gases they are liberated. So when we have to calculate the volume of the gas, then what formula we will use? The volume that is equal to IT. Equivalent volume, VE over here, that is the equivalent volume upon 96500. Okay, so this is the volume of the gas which is liberated, current, time, equivalent volume upon 96500. How do we calculate the equivalent volume for gases? Right, let's take an example. For example, when we have to calculate for oxygen, we know that the atomic mass of oxygen, that is equal to 16. Okay, sorry, the molecular mass, because it exists in the molecular form. The molecular form of oxygen, mass of oxygen, that is 32. Right, and the equivalent mass of oxygen, that is equal to 8. Okay, now if we say that if 32 grams at STP, it liberates or it gives 22.4 liters, is equal to 22.4 liters. 1 gram will be equal to 22.4 divided by 32, and 8 grams will be equal to 22.4 upon 32 into 8. Okay, so this is how you will calculate the equivalent volume, which comes to 5.6 liters. Similarly, you can also calculate for chlorine. We know that the molecular weight of chlorine, that is equal to 71, equivalent weight of chlorine, that is equal to 35.5. So if 71 grams is equal to 22.4 liters, then 35.5 grams, that will be equal to how much? Half of this, which is 11.2 liters. So you take the equivalent volume over here of the gas, the current pass, time, and divided by 96500, we will get the volume of the gas liberated. Okay, then there are many applications of electrolysis. We had done electrolysis the other day. Go on to applications of electrolysis. The first application of electrolysis we had already discussed, to determine the equivalent weight of the metal or non-metal. So I am putting over here of the substance, right? Determining the equivalent weight of the substance. So what was the formula we did that day? Weight of metal A upon weight of metal B, that is equal to equivalent weight of A upon equivalent weight of B. Okay? Then the second one is electrometallurgy. The second application electrometallurgy. Right, now when we are talking of electrometallurgy, it is the extraction of metals with respect to electrolysis or with the help of electrolysis. For example, when we want to extract, say, sodium, so we take a fused electrolyte of sodium chloride, calcium chloride and potassium chloride. When electrolysis of this fused electrolyte is done, the metal deposited is going to be pure sodium. ठीक है? In a similar manner, if we want to extract calcium from a fused mixture of calcium chloride and calcium chloride, electrolysis of this is done to give us pure calcium. Okay, other metals which can be extracted are aluminium, magnesium, potassium. These are few metals which can be extracted. Then third is manufacture of normal metals. There are many gases which are liberated at the anode during the process of electrolysis. For example, we have done a few examples also, like hydrogen. We did the processes in which we have taken aqueous NaOH. So for aqueous NaOH, hydrogen that was liberated at the cathode. Then chlorine was liberated at the anode, right? And then we have oxygen. All the non-metals, they mostly are liberated at the anode. Exception over here is that of hydrogen. Right? So oxygen is liberated, chlorine is liberated in a similar manner. We can also prepare fluorine. So this was another application of electrolysis. The next application is electro-refining of metals. There are many metals which are refined by electrolysis. For example, copper, silver, gold. Copper, silver, gold, etc. They all are refined by electrolysis process. Okay. And then a very, very important use of electrolysis is electroplating, that is coating of inferior metal by a superior metal. Okay, so coating of inferior metal, we have some inferior metal and we want to make it look more beautiful or enhance the properties, like it does not undergo rusting. So for that we do electroplating, right? Now in electroplating, basically what is done? We know that the metal that is deposited at the cathode. Okay, so we take a suitable electrolyte over here and the substance to be coated, let's say we are coating a spatula. So substance to be coated, that is taken as the cathode, and the pure metal is taken as the anode and the cell that is set up. Okay, so this is going to be the cathode, negatively charged, and this is the anode, positively charged. Let's say we want to electroplate this spoon with silver. So the anode that will be made up of silver. Anode will undergo oxidation, as a result of which it will lose the metal from here, and that metal will be electroplated on this. Okay, so this electroplating is of wide importance, because we have gold plated ornaments, we have silver plated jewelry, then we have silver plated cutlery. There are many things which are done. Even iron is sometimes electroplatelized in order to reduce the process of rusting. Galvanization, which is known as that we are coating the piece of iron with zinc. Okay, so this is electroplating. Is it clear? Okay. Phir uske baad, there is another thing which is very, very important. Sometimes you get in the questions. To calculate the thickness of the metal deposited. Okay, so we are calculating the thickness of coated layer, right? Now when we are going to do this, for this we know that according to Faraday's law, W that is equal to what? ZIT, that is MIT upon N into 96500, right? We also know that density, that is equal to mass upon volume. Therefore, mass or weight deposited, that will be equal to density into volume, M. So this over here will become as volume into density, that is equal to MIT upon N into 96500. Right? We also know that volume, that is equal to area into thickness. Clear? So putting the value of volume over here, we will get area into thickness into density, that is equal to MIT upon 96500N. So from here we can calculate the thickness of the coated layer. Okay, then another syntax, what happens is that the efficiency, the current which is produced during electrolysis, that is less. Okay, so in order to calculate the current efficiency, that how much of the current which is flown along the cell, that is efficient, we can calculate the current efficiency as percentage of current that is equal to actual current upon ammeter current into 100, right? Actual current upon ammeter current into 100, that is the current efficiency. So if in case you need to calculate the current efficiency, this is how we can calculate. Now today we are going to do a few questions regarding the Faraday's laws. Let's see what are the type of questions which can come in your examination. The first question is, how much charge is required to reduce 1 mole of Al3 positive to Al and 1 mole of MnO4 negative to Mn2 positive? Okay, so let's go on to the first part of the reaction. Al3 positive to Al means that Al3 positive will gain 3 electrons and get reduced to Al, right? So for the ratio over here is 1 mole is to 3 moles. That 1 mole requires how many electrons? It is requiring 3 moles of electrons. Now Q, that is equal to what? Q is equal to NF. Okay, so N over here, that is going to be equal to 3. So Q will become 3 into 96500, and that when calculated, it is coming to 289500 coulombs. 285900 coulombs. These type of questions are quite common. Now you have to keep it in mind that whatever the number of moles of electrons are, they are going to be multiplied by 96500. In a similar manner, the second part of the question, that is given as MnO4 negative to Mn2 positive. So let's calculate the electron exchange over here. the oxidation state of manganese over here, that is going to come as +7. Okay, so manganese oxidation state changes from +7 to +2. So there are going to be how much? +5 electrons. The electron exchange over here is +5. Therefore, what is going to be Q now? Q is equal to NF, that is equal to 5 into 96500, and when we calculate this, it comes to 482500. Coulombs. Clear? So this is how this question has to be done. Then the next question is also of the similar kind. How much electric charge is required to oxidize 1 mole of H2O2O2 and 1 mole of FeO2Fe2O3? Part A. The question is, how much electric charge is required to oxidize 1 mole of H2O2O2? So let's see the number of electron exchange over here. H2O, that is going to break into what? It will break into half of O2 plus 2H positive, and the electron exchange in this case is going to be 2 electrons. Right? So what is going to be Q over here now? Again, NF 2 into 96500 coulombs. Okay, so this is coming as 193,000 coulombs. In a similar manner, let's go on to the second part, FeO2Fe2O3. So FeO gets hydrolyzed to Fe2O3 plus hydrogen, and the electron exchange in this case is only one electron exchange. This can also be calculated in a very easier manner. Just look at the oxidation state of iron over here. It is +2, and the oxidation state over here, that is going to be equal to +3. So only one electron exchange is taking place. Therefore, Q that becomes equal to, again, NF is equal to 1 into 96500 coulomb. What is question number 3? An electric current of 100 amperes passed through a molten liquid of sodium chloride for 5 hours. Calculate the volume of chlorine gas liberated at the electrode at NTP. So the what is the formula we are going to use? Volume, that is equal to ITVE upon N into F, N into 96500. So, what is the current which is given to us in the question? An electric current of 100 ampere. So, let's put the value 100. Okay. A molten liquid 5 hours. 5 hours have to be calculated into seconds. So, 5 into 60. Into 60. Number of electron exchange, that will be equal to 2. Okay. So, number of electron exchange is 2. Into 96500. Now the equivalent weight of chlorine we had just discussed, that will be equal to 35.5, isn't it? What is the equivalent weight? That is equal to, we just calculated, 35.5. So when we calculate this, it is coming to 208.91 liters. Clear? Let's go to question number 4. What is question number 4? A 100 watt, 110 volt incandescent lamp is connected in series with an electrolytic cell containing cadmium sulfate solution. What mass of cadmium will be deposited by current flowing for 10 hours? Okay, so when we are going to calculate, we have to calculate current over here. How do we calculate current over here? The formula for current is watt, that is equal to ampere into volt. So both of these are given to us in the question. They are saying a 100 watt bulb. So 100 ampere into 110 volt. So ampere will be equal to 100 divided by 110. That is equal to ampere. Okay. And then what we can do is we have to calculate W. So W, that will be equal to what? Atomic mass into I into T upon N into F. This is the formula. Okay. So two electron exchange is going to take place for cadmium. Right? So mass of cadmium deposited, that will be equal to what? Ampere. What is the atomic mass of cadmium? It is 112.4. 112.4. So what do we have over here? Weight deposited, that will be equal to, you also have to keep over here the atomic mass. Atomic mass I have placed over here. A. Okay? So 100 and what did I say? It is 112.4. Current given is 10 hours. So 10 hours have to be calculated or converted into seconds into 60 into 60. Right? So N over here, that is going to be equal to 2 into 96500 coulombs. Right? So when we calculate this, the answer comes to 19.05 grams. 19.05 grams, that is the answer. Clear? Let's go to question number 5. Let's see what is question number 5. In an electrolysis experiment, a current was passed for 5 hours through 2 cells connected in series. The first cell contains a solution of gold salt and the second cell contains copper sulfate solution. 9.85 grams of gold was deposited in the first cell. If the oxidation number of gold is plus 3, find the amount of copper deposited on the cathode in the second cell. Also calculate the magnitude of current in ampere. Okay, so for this we are going to apply the second law of Faraday, that is weight of gold deposited upon weight of copper deposited, that is equal to equivalent weight of gold upon equivalent weight of copper. This is the second law of Faraday. Okay, so equivalent mass of gold will be what? The mass of gold, that is the atomic mass of gold, is 197. Okay, so equivalent mass of gold, that will be equal to the number of electron exchange is 3 positive. Gold ki jo valency hai, that is 3 positive. So that will be equal to the atomic mass of gold, which is 197 divided by 3. Okay, in a similar manner, we can also calculate the equivalent weight of copper. The atomic mass of copper, that is 63.5. And the valency of copper, that is 2. So equivalent weight, that is going to be this. Then mass of copper deposited will become how much? We know the mass of gold over here. What did they say? The mass of gold deposited, that is how much? 9.85 grams. So let's put the values. Okay. 9.85 upon weight of copper, that is equal to 197 upon 3, and we are dividing, so reciprocal 2 upon 63.5. So W of copper will become how much? 3 into 9.85 into 63.5 upon 2 into 197. That is the weight of copper. So this when calculated, it comes to 4.7625. Okay. But now the question does not end over here. We have to calculate, find the amount of copper deposited on the cathode in the second cell. Okay. So in this case, weight deposited is given to us. I is to be calculated. I current has to be calculated over here. Clear? Weight we have, so let's put the first law, W that is equal to ZID, right? So W is given to us and Z will be equal to what? Atomic mass of copper into I into T upon N, N that will become equal to 2 into 96500. So W given to us over here is, which we just calculated, let's take it as 4.76, right? Atomic mass of copper that is equal to 63.5. I we have to calculate. Time given in the question that is 5 hours. Hana? Yes. So 5 hours has to be converted into seconds. 5 into 60 into 60 upon 2 into 96500. Right? So when we calculate I from here, the value of I that is coming as 0.804 ampere. Clear? Okay, so let's go to question number 6. Question number 6 is, how long has a current of 3 ampere to be applied through a solution of silver nitrate to coat a metal surface of 80 cm square with 0.005 mm thick layer? Density of silver is 10.5. So what is the formula which we are going to use over here? Area into thickness into density, that is equal to atomic mass into I into T upon NF. Okay, so what is the area given to us over here? That is 80 centimeter into thickness given to us is 0.005 mm. So 0.005 mm ko when we calculate in centimeter, it will become 0.0005 into density. Density given to us is 10.5. Let's take this N also on the other side. So N over here is what is the metal given to us? Silver. So N would be 1. 96500 upon atomic mass of silver, that is 108, right? So 108 into current given to us is how much? Solution 3 ampere. So into 3, that is going to be equal to T. Right? So when we calculate T from here, T that comes to 125.09 seconds. 125.09 seconds. Got it? Let's go to question number 7. Question number 7 is 0.2964 grams of copper was deposited on passage of current of 0.5 ampere for 30 minutes through a solution of copper sulfate. Calculate the atomic mass of copper. So, how will we calculate this? We will put the first law of Faraday, right? So, first law of Faraday says W that is equal to atomic mass into IA into T upon NF. Okay, so what is atomic mass given to us? Copper here, so copper ka atomic mass is going to be 63.5. Okay, current given to us in the question is 0.5. And time given to us in the question is how much? 30 minutes. So convert it into seconds. 30 into 60. For copper, N is going to be equal to 2 into 96500. Right? So this, when calculated, it comes to 63.56. The answer coming is 63.56. Oh, we have to calculate the atomic mass. This has to be calculated. And this is given to us. This has to be calculated. And this is given to us, 0.264. So A, when calculated, it comes to 63.56. Okay? Have you understood? Then let's go to question number 8. Question number 8 is 19 grams of molten SnCl2 is electrolyzed for some time using inert electrodes until 0.119 grams of tin is deposited at the cathode. No substance is lost during electrolysis. Find the ratio of mass of SnCl2 to SnCl4 after electrolysis. Okay, so in this case, let's first write a balanced equation. This is going to be the balanced equation. Okay. Now, when we talking of atomic mass of tin, that is 119. So, we calculate the molar mass of this, that will come to 190. 71 plus 119, that comes to 190. Okay. In a similar manner, the molecular mass of this will become as 261. And that of tin, that is 119. Okay, so 119 of tin is deposited by the decomposition of how much of tin chloride? 360. Okay, so we are writing, so 119 grams of tin is deposited by 360 grams of SnCl2. So 0.119 will be deposited by how much? 0.119 of grams of tin will be deposited by how much? 0.119 means 360 divided by 119 into 0.119. So that will become equal to 0.36. Right? So it will become equal to 0.380. Right? Remaining amount of SnCl2 left will be how much? They have given us 19 grams of molten. So, remaining SnCl2 that will be equal to 19 minus 0.380. ठीक है, so this comes to 18.62 grams. So 380 of SnCl2 is giving us how much of SnCl4? 261. So 380 of SnCl2 gives us 261 grams of SnCl4, and 18.62 will give us how much? First of all, let's calculate 0.380 will give us how much, because that is the SnCl2 which is used over here. Okay, so 0.380, that will give us how much? 261 upon 380 into 0.380. So that will become equal to 0.261. Okay, now after doing this, when we have calculated, so let's calculate the ratio of SnCl2 after the finishing of the reaction. Ratio of SnCl2 and SnCl4. Okay, so SnCl2 is how much? 18.62. Upon 0.261. ठीक है, so this is the ratio, so the ratio is coming as 71.35:1.